If you don't believe me, I'll take you to the place. Let's go. See, this is my terrace. You can see. And this is the stick. See it clearly. This is the stick from where I got the idea of making the old man and stick story. When I saw this stick, I got the idea. But believing is up to you now. Guys, I would like to tell you a story. Naresh wants to become a writer. He quits his recruiting job to follow his passion. Everyone calls him a waste fellow, but he never minds it. One day he writes a motivational story and publishes it. A person named Kamal comes to him with his son and says, "Naresh, where did you steal your recently published story?" "What? Are you kidding?" Naresh says. Naresh thinks that person is just joking, but Kamal says, "You have stolen this story and published under your name. You are a fraud." Naresh shocks by this. He rubs his eyes to confirm is it real or not. "Sir, what are you saying? It is my story. I have written it," says Naresh. "You fraud, stealing others' work and claiming it's yours." Naresh says, "Sir, I'm publishing my stories on YouTube. All rights reserved." Kamal says, "Your story was ancient Buddhist tale. Unpublish it as soon as possible." By hearing that, Naresh's heart breaks. He thinks, how much effort I have put in to write it. Today this guy is claiming that I have stolen it. What is happening? "Sir, it is my own story," says Naresh. "What is the proof?" Kamal asks. "I am the proof." "You claim it yourself? We need evidence." Naresh thinks for some time and says, "Sir, who is this kid?" "He is my little son," says Kamal. "What is the proof?" "Proof? What are you talking?" Person gets angry. "Is he really born to you? I need evidence, sir." "How dare you talk to me like this?" Kamal says and catches Naresh's collar. Naresh laughs and says, "Now you understand my pain?" "Even I have felt the same pain when you asked me that question." "What if I say you stole this kid from Ramesh uncle?" "Oh, really? I can prove he is my son by DNA test." "What about you, fraud?" says Kamal. "Okay, sir, let's go to the hospital," says Naresh. They go to the hospital. Father and son gives their blood sample for test. Some days later, test result is out. Test result brings earthquake in Kamal's house. Naresh shocks by the report. Kamal cannot digest this. He collapses at once. Kamal goes to depression. Naresh feels sad and thinks, how report stated kid is not the son of Kamal? Something is mysterious. I know he is Kamal's son, but everyone insults Kamal. Kamal cries a lot. Writer Naresh starts investigating how this has happened. Eventually, after a month, Naresh finds that DNA report was misprinted. Finally, truth gets revealed. It is proven that kid is Kamal's son. Suddenly, God appears. Naresh and Kamal kneels down.
"Kamal,
your behavior has brought you to this stage. You alleged Naresh has stolen the story. Judging without any proof is wrong. You don't have any proof, but stated Naresh is a fraud. Even kid is your son, report then prove it first. What do you understand by this?" "I wanted you to understand the pain when no one believes us, even if it is the truth. If you have proof, try to prove it. If he is wrong, he will be proven guilty one day. I am watching everything." Kamal becomes speechless. Writer says, "I'll tell you how did I get old man and stick story." Yesterday I got these comments to one of my videos. I was literally shocked after reading the comment. I don't know how people comment like this without knowing the truth. I don't know. But It's like heartbreaking. Whenever we do nothing, everyone says that you're useless, you're a waste fellow. Everyone say like this, but when we do something like this, people say, where did you get this from? Where did you steal this? Oh my God, it's really, I can't even express the feeling, the pain, what I'm going through now. If you ask me, how can I prove myself that I am the writer of these stories? How can I prove myself? If you really doubt me, just go and watch all my videos. You will get a clarity over me, the way of my stories and way of telling the stories, all are different stories and different and there will be a unique way of storytelling. It's not easy. It's not easy that we can steal someone else's work and name it as the thing what we are the creator of that. It's not easy. It's not at all right. Actually, I'm writing stories to give good message to the people. And how can I be a fraud? This is literally shocking. I'm just using Buddha as a teaching character in all my stories, because Buddha is meant for teaching the people what is right and what is wrong. So I thought using the Buddha would be better to tell stories to the people, to guide them what is right and what is wrong, the moral of the story. But it doesn't mean that all the stories are Buddhist stories and these are written by someone else. It's not right. I am the writer of all these stories. I strongly say that you don't get any of these stories else anywhere. That's it, because these stories are all mine. I have created all these stories. In every video, I express my sincere thanks to all the people who helped me in making this, in making the video. It may be a software, it may be the pictures and videos that I collect from other sources to make the video, to tell the story. So I put them in the end credits. I'm grateful to them. That's it. It says that I don't steal anyone's property. That's not my character. Whether you believe or not, this is the fact you must understand.